So my mom was this very eccentric woman who was going to do what she wanted to do, and she was going to do it her way. She was an absolute artist and really was truly about creating beauty in the world. And then also to give that beauty, whether it was in the form of jewelry or a mug or socks. So when she first started, she really was about giving, and she was always creating, always. I would go to school and come home from school, and there'd be a wall that was magenta, you know, and it wasn't like that when I left for school in the morning. You know how you go into some homes and you feel like, oh my God, I can't touch anything? It was not like that. It was warm and inviting and a beautiful environment. She wanted us to feel free. She grew up she was born in 1945. You know, her mom was a seamstress for Peggy Lee and was, you know, much, although she was an artist as well, but she was much more conservative. So when my mom, you know, had us in the 60s, you know, white woman married to a black man, you know, started in the Haight-Ashbury, she was gonna do whatever she wanted to do, you know, and hippie to the max. So my mom really got her start by creating these one-of-a-kind pieces and selling them at street fairs, like the Grant Street Fair, the Haight Street Fair, the Renaissance Fair. So, you know, she literally would make a few pairs of earrings, you know, every day, and maybe have six pairs of earrings, and she would just want to sell a couple so she'd have money to pay for dinner. So I remember when my mom, years ago, it's probably 25 years ago, came home and said, you know, I'm doing socks now. She was so thrilled that she could put art on people's feet. Today, it's really significant for me to connect with partners that I can relate to, that I feel are doing good work out there. And Socksmith checked every box for me. I think we're moving into a time of even more so wanting to, you know, state your, how do you express yourself? What better way is there than adorning your feet?